Hey, Gobi, guys. There's a crack, and that I suggest, or I think, the war is more between EFF and MK Party, and one will even go as far as saying it was probably caused by the fact that Chivambo has moved from one political party to another, being from EFF and look, moving from EFF to MK Party. There's an official statement from the MK Party condemning the behavior of certain people. And if you go deeper into this, you will notice the tone of the message in the very same in the audio itself. So we'll definitely talk about that. Another thing that I want us to talk about is the fact that the Concord has issues directives in AfriForum's case against Judge Hlophe. We'll talk about that because a lot of people are saying it is so strange that when MK Party and other people were seeking direct access to the Concord, they were refused. But now it's AfriForum against MK Party. Quickly, they want to jump into that and accept that, right? There's another DA councillor that was struck by the local LPC. But this person is still practicing as a lawyer. People have broken their silence concerning that. There is a petition that we need to talk about concerning the mayor of Gauteng. The petition wants him to step down. Ngizwe Mqhunu again has done it again and found himself into some problems, right? It has been said that, look, I saw the videos of him being in a look in an airline. They started singing and doing some things there. So those are the stories that I want us to cover in today's video. But one that also catches my attention is the fact that this DA, the DA local MP struck off by the LPC serves in the legislature. An article released by Thabo Makwakwa, DAMP is Henriette van Steenstra, who has been struck off and suspended by the Legal Practice Council, serves as a lawmaker in the Northwest Legislature. It has been said, yeah, member. Okay, the reason I'm also mentioning this is because you've got advocate therefore that was struck off by the legal practice, but you know he hasn't been he's been in jail. So how is she practicing? You know, we'll talk about that. Talk about the cracks in the Progressive Caucus. We'll talk about that. But before we can move forward, I would also appreciate if you can do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, so let's start here, okay, guys. Let's start with this one. Yeah, look, it says that Van Heystan emerged as number three ahead of many other candidates of the IEC list of the DA in the Northwest Legislature, where she is currently served since June 14. Right? According to reports, this person was suspended by the LPC, which is statutory regulator body regulating the legal pro local profession. This was for her failure to submit an audit report and practicing without Fidelity Fund certificate since 2019. Sources within DA told the publication that the party was soft on white but dealt harshly with black members, says EIOL. In the media, we keep hearing about how they don't want Busisiwe Mkhwebane and John Hlophe to participate in parliament as lawmaker, but they don't hesitate to leviate a white woman despite clear evidence that she is not fit to even be trusted with responsibility to protect the law as expected from a legal practitioner. Very interesting one, and I thought I should bring this because remember in one of my video I said to you guys, in a previous video I said I've got a problem with the fact that if you follow these people, they'll drive you crazy. They'll make you mad, I'm telling you. Here's the thing. I told you guys that these organizations that you talk of undoing tax, Save SA, Freedom and the Law, you name them. You must notice they never react when it is a white person. They never. Last example is what happened in Cape Town. What happened with this guy who was a racist, even though there was evidence. Did you ever hear anything about that person? Never. But I'm telling you, let it be Abo Machela Koko, Abo Brian Molefe, the very first organization, let it be Abo Judge Hlophe. They are the very first people to go there and say, we are defending the Constitution. We will defend the Constitution. And I always say to you guys, how do you defend the Constitution against the race? Because then we are creating a narrative that only one race can sin. The other race cannot sin. Do you notice what I'm saying? So now you understand why this article was important. Let's look at this. Approach for comment. Owen Hersen did not respond to the question from the Sunday Independent. The DA chair in the Northwest, as well as the party federal chair, Helen Zille, had not responded to questions from the publication. The LPC confirmed through the National Senior Administrator, Siviwe Mololi, that Van Hersen was struck off and suspended by the body. Henriette Van Hersen was admitted and enrolled within the Northwest Division in November 2016, was suspended on the 2nd of December 2021, and she remained suspended, Molloy said. Right? Despite evidence that Van Hersen was struck off and suspended by the LPC, the DA, which has always boosted that it only deployed the best vetted individual among its ranks, the party in the Northwest issued a statement welcoming this person in the legislature soon after she was sewn in. Okay, they said that, look, they go on and say that it's a symbol of dedication to the public service, but also the democratic echoes an inclusive representation within the Northwest Provincial. Her role is posed to contribute positively to legislative processes, financial oversight, and the advancement of the policies that resonate with needs and aspiration of communities across, they name the places. Now, please note that these are the people that when they give you this person, they said this person is going to do all this excellent work. Remember, listen to this one. Meanwhile, the DA chief whip in the National Assembly, George Chakalan, said in June, it is neither reasonable nor rational to elect MK chief whip Dr. John Hlophe as a representative of the National Assembly on the Judicial Service Commission, JSC, after the DA and the ANC successfully voted for the removal of Hlophe. The first is that the matter of public record that Dr. John Hlophe lost the statute as a judge of the High Court in South Africa as a consequence of finding gross misconduct by the judicial service. This decision taken today is further not merely a public decision, but also exercise of public power aimed at contributing to the establishment of very same Judicial Service Commission. Now, Now, those are the words of ETA when George Hlophe was being elected. They said that this is not going to be a good thing, Bona. They are going to save South Africa from the people who are crooks, who's got. Now, they deployed the very same person at Northwest. Very same person is deployed at Northwest. Tell me, I told you, these organizations, they never talk. When it is a black person, they never respond. When it's a white person, they never, but let it be a black person. They are the first people to tell you how much they want to save the Constitution. Look, on that note as well, Concord issued directives in AfriForum's case against Hlophe's appointment to JSC. Listen to this one. On Monday, the court issued directives ordering the respondent in the case to submit answering affidavit to AfriForum's application direct access to the Concord. In July, AfriForum requested direct access to Concord to declare Hlophe's appointment to the JSC irrational, unlawful, and or contrary to the National Assembly constitution duty. Right? So you notice that these people are able to fight and defend the constitution, right? And I always tell you, it has never been about the constitution. It has always been about color. I'm going to say this again. It has never been about constitution, but it has always been about color of a skin. Let it be people of a certain color. They are quick to take them before court so they can be declared let me give you this word. Now let's go to the letter here, MK Party here. It has been said that hey Gubi. Listen to the letter. Let me read this letter from MK Party. It says that MK Party Youth League expressed its deep concern and profound disappointment over the recent actions that have disrupted the unity and within the Progressive Caucus. This caucus, representing 102 seats in National Assembly, uniting the forces of Umkhonto we Sizwe, MKP, the Economic Freedom Fighter, EFF, the African Transformation Movement, ATM, National Colored Congress, NCC, and United African Transformation, UAT, was established with the clear objective opposing an earlier past masquerading as national unity. The Progressive Caucus Charter outlines our broader mission beyond parliamentary confines to mobilize, collaborate with all progressive formation of working classes, landless, traditional and religious leaders, and all oppressed people in our country and beyond. This united front is not just a political alliance, it is a movement dedicated to achieving total liberation and total liberation, equality, decolonization, economic freedom for all. It is therefore, listen to this one. It is therefore unacceptable and disheartening that this unity is now being undermined from within. Now, please notice this. This unity is being undermined from within. Don't you think that was caused by the move of Shivambu from one political party to another? I mean, come to think of it. There was a natural instinct to me. It tells me that, but let me continue. From within, by certain individuals who prioritize personal agendas over collective good, the Progressive Caucus was not formed to serve as a stage for ego-driven, theatric or petty power struggle. Our mandate is to fortify the opposition in parliament and advance the cause of true liberation for our people. We call upon the leadership within caucus to remember to remember the fundamental principle that unites us. By engaging in divisive behavior and failing to comprehend the significance of selfless decision made for advancement of our revolution is not just disappointing, it is betrayal of every people we represent. Such conduct is not only unbecoming, but also morally repugnant. Right. Let it be known that a greater leader does not embark on a heartbreak tour when faced with challenges, but instead pulls back, regroup, focuses on the task at hand. True leaders understand the gravity of their responsibility and prioritize the collective mission over personal grievances. They focus on what matters most, advancing the revolution. In the name of our people and the revolution, we must stand united, focused and unwavering in our pursuit of total liberation. Now, please notice that there are funny words that are being used here, which are very interesting. They are saying people are focusing on grievances, right? Who's aggrieved? And I want to ask you that question, who's aggrieved? I told you, they have already given us a very nice clue here that there is a person who is aggrieved by certain things that are happening here. And this person is using this now as a stage. You know what I'm saying? It just suits my lemma. I don't know why, but it just suits my lemma. And I'll tell you why I'm saying that. It just suits him. Let me tell you why I'm saying that. Do you remember what he did when he called the press conference? Here we are giving a description of Malema because he calls a press conference. In the press conference, he puts Undlonze under the bus. Do you remember that? Yay! Yay! So here for me, the MK party has given us all hints that we need. That there are people who are being disruptive in this. Okay. I said, interesting. Another interesting story. There's a petition. Petition seeking the removal of mayor reaches 10,000. More than 10,000 people have signed an online petition calling for the removal of Joburg mayor Dada Morero. Okay. Pressure is mounting on Morero, who was appointed to the position 2 weeks ago, to step down after he proposed recruitment of foreign national into the Joburg Metro Department, JMPD, to address rampant crime. On Monday, Morero, why am I tired, was forced to apologize after a video of him addressing the ANC meeting went viral on social media. In his capacity as the ANC regional chairperson, he suggested that foreign nationals who are legally in the country should be hired to assist with the language interpretation barriers during crime prevention operation. This was, however, met with widespread criticism and calls for him to be removed as a mayor. Morero, who was the former city of Joburg MEC of Finance, was elected as a mayor after resigned. So I'm reading from a Jacaranda FM news. Obviously, they released an article. Now, I don't know what to say about the petition. I want to say something, but I just don't know what to say. And angifuna kuba ungomo yayona. Sisuke ku ngomo yayona. Siye komunye ungomo yayona. Guess who's that? Gizwe Mkhunu disruptive behavior on a plane resurface. Okay? I saw those videos. And then it has been reported the following. Okay. Let me just give me this one. Gizwe Mkhunu has been lambasted for allegedly creating havoc on an airline, right? A video of the controversial former Ukhozi FM, blah, blah, blah. Now, I wonder if it is not possible for these companies to ban you. You know, you get told that you're not going to be using our plane anymore, or you know what I'm saying? I'm just wondering if it's not possible that you can get banned for misbehaving. But again, it says next month is Heritage Month, and we are Africans. Next month. Guys, I don't know what I'm reading. Next month is Heritage Month, and we as Africans exercise our right to embrace our different cultures and traditions. Why do Africans always always get oppressed in everything they do culturally? I did nothing wrong. Guess who said that? Not me. Guess who said that? Not me. Then you get Flies. It's called what? Fly Surfer Marketing Officer Gabon says the cabin crew on flight FA169 encountered a group of passengers whose behavior was disruptive and in violation of standard aviation safety protocol, including adherence to safety bell signs. Our safety and security team is finalizing its review on the incident. Appropriate actions will be taken in accordance within our procedure, with many including bearing the individuals involved in future fly safe flights. Oh, I was just asking myself about that. Oguti, can't you get banned from using their planes? I don't know. If you have not seen the video, it's a pity I don't have the video. But I think I can conclude that by saying I feel like sometimes some of the things I'm still trying to think, how best can I say this? You know, sometimes I feel like, in as much as I think we expect white people to, in as much as we expect white people to respect black people, but I think at the same time, black people must also respect white people. You know, I looked at that behavior, I saw that video, and I was like, I wonder if this is not going to get some people into trouble. I wonder if this is not going to get some people into trouble with the airline. Now they are thinking along those lines. The question is, was it necessary? You know, considering the fact that it's like being in a taxi. You can't assume that everybody belongs to your race or your culture or whatever. You have to assume that we are from different walks of life, so we are here to do nothing but to respect one another. And when that doesn't happen, then you know what I'm saying. It's disheartening. I don't want to lie to you. It is very disheartening. But what can we then say if these things are so? Going back to the issue as we conclude this video, going back to the issue of MK Party and EFF, the description that they've given us there, it says to me there is a war within the caucus, the Progressive Caucus. There is a serious war there. It might have been caused by the moving or the move of Ushivambo, because listen to the description of the description of what they are saying there, and they're just describing Malema. I stand under the conduction of my man Bonanda Simso, but for me, I just kind of feel like Malema. You know what I'm saying? I just kind of feel like Malema, 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 Malema. You know. I don't know. Tell me what you think about it. But I feel like a clue has already been provided there. So let me take something, guys. I don't know why my noise is doing this to me in the middle of a recording. It must respect, man, that I'm recording video. Oh, yeah. Thank you very much. Guys, don't you think we should end the video here? I think the video is very long. Let's end the video here.